West Ascension Consolidated Gravity Drain District meeting is called to order for November 6, 2014. Mr. Shakespeare, would you do the invocation?
Dear Lord, we want to thank you for all the good things you've given us here in Ascension Parish, the benefits and the great people that we have here. I'd like to ask that you give us, you know, keep us in your prayers, especially for George and his wife Jeannie, who's recently lost their son, and Mr. Boo also, for his loss and their family. We ask that you allow us to make good decisions tonight and everyone get home safely to their families, and we have a great week. We ask all this in your name. Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all. Roll call, Mr. Shakespeare, here, all is present. Accepting the minutes for August 7, 2014. Moved by Mr. Shakespeare, second by myself. Motion passed. Item number four, West 7th Street. Myself, Councilman Joseph, talked to the mayor. They do have the bid in a contractor to do the job in the past, just to bring up the speed, the cost of it. We was going to do half, and my understanding of it as of right now, we need a intergovernmental agreement or
cooperative endeavor agreement.
Corporate endeavor agreement.
Intergovernmental agreement is two governmental bodies.
Okay. Okay. So I guess the other thing is then we need to send them a letter stating that, and that way we have records showing that we.
I would like to make a motion that we request an intergovernmental agreement from the town. The contract process, because since we're involved, so that legal can review, and a scope of work for just for review, and to keep with our records, and we will address it at the next meeting, so we
and
can take
care of
it.
Provide us an invoice.
Yes. Parish President, do you have anything to, any other news? We don't know anything else other than that.
All right, that's item number four. Moving on to item number five. That's also one of my items. On Carroll Street, Mr. Roy Davis have a house that he have been here before, and he got hot water in his house three times. And we really, we thought we had a solution one time across the street by digging a ditch on the individual property, but we didn't have right of way, and the individual didn't want us to go on his property. So Mr. Roy have asked me to look at another option, what we can do to prevent it. I mean, he's only about 500 or 600 feet from the 308, so he on high ground. It's just a drainage problem, and we just need to look at another way of getting that water out of there. We do have a culvert in there. It's about a 24-inch, I would think, behind his house, going across.
20 or 24, one or two.
Right. But apparently, it's just not big enough. The water is not getting out that area fast enough. So I'm asking that we look at that and come back with some options, what we can do. Mr. President.
That's repetitive loss through through parish HMGP projects, and that's one of the qualifications. and you have to be over 50% damage that you claim through insurance, so it's...
If you did that, but if you get with Martha, then they give them an opportunity.
We definitely need to get people in the parish, if they flood, to put their names in on a list so that we can, as these things develop, or if a parish gets funds, we can do the criteria that will help get them in that assistance program.
No, not that I know of. I just...
If you, we check with, I mean, you may not meet all the criteria, but it's a possibility.
Okay, all right. We definitely will get Mr. Davis to, what you call him. So I guess the same thing with item number six.
We get, could we get a survey crew or what you suggest, George, to look at, to come up with some ideas about possibilities? Do we need a survey crew? Do we need...
Yeah, we'll talk to them and we'll get them to come over and look at it.
Yeah, you would need a survey crew, because if you're changing, thinking of changing that cover right by his house, you'll have to go down the land and start changing covers too.
Right, that's what I...
Smaller. Get the water to go to the back.
Let's get some options and then the cost of those options and we'll see.
We'll look at it.
Okay.
Moving on to item number six, and that's Bonnie Land and Caldana Street.
Okay, yeah.
All right.
Okay.
And I got Mr. Steve Miles. His house had flooded two times in the last, one of them was the big rain and the other one. Just a little history on this here. This is something new. Their whole block go to one ditch and it drained to that one ditch on Caldonia Street goes to St. Patrick Street. And the cover that we need to look at is, everyone look at it, and we think it need to be enlarged. It going across Bonnie Street. Talk to the mayor about it, and they said it is enlarged that cover, but once again, it crossing a city street, and he told me that if we change out the cover, they would take care of the street or the driveway, the cement and stuff and all that, reforming and doing that. Once again, I know we probably have to have some type of agreement. I would like to request that Mr. George Redillion get with the city and verify those things and get with the attorneys and we come up with some type of agreement. But once again, Mr. Steve Miles' house was built, was one of the first houses, the lowest house. All the rest of the houses pretty much stay safe, but when the rain come, he get water in his house. I know Craig, myself, the mayor, and looked at it. George, I think you've been out there.
Several times.
Right. He's the only resident in that whole block have major problems with that because it's just low. So as the president do, I would definitely get with Martha to get with them and evaluate them too. So, but if all possible, we can get there and get with the city, Downsville, and work out some detail with a
We'll look at, we've already dug all the ditches down Caledonia Street. We were gonna do a little bit more digging down Bonnie Lane, I think, next week. Yeah. And we'll look at the culvert crossing the road on Bonnie Lane. I'm not looking at any driveways. I'm looking at the culvert crossing the road, mm-hmm. Okay? We can, we'll have to get O'Neill, we'll talk about it, a government agreement probably that too, to make sure that they go back and put the road back. We can get our cutter from across the road, cut the road, we can pull the culvert and drop it. That's not a big deal, as long as they put the road back. I just don't want to cut anybody's driveway. We'll look at it. Craig will look at it next week and we'll get it set up. All right?
All right. It's shaking out, Lenny?
Nope.
Nope. All right. Moving on. Item number seven is the master drainage. Right of covers and wide way. Mr. O'Neill, I know you have been busy, so.
But I did talk to the attorney who represents the landowners. They're very satisfied with the work that we've been working with them, and they're eager to do some more work with us as soon as grinding's over. They're not going to do anything till after grinding.
Okay, good enough. All right, Smoke Bend, Boston Long Drive. Mr. George, I know we cleaned everything so far, it been working.
Everything's been working good. I haven't had any problems. We've been watching it. Craig and I both, Craig lives in that area, so we're good. We're good there. Yeah, I think we need to remove that one for now. If it comes up again, we'll bring it back to the board.
I agree with you on that one there. So, Ms. Peggy, we can remove item number eight. St. James Assumption Drainage Update. I'm pretty sure this is the major one that.
Well, as we know, it's basically the same. I've talked to Jody Chenier this week by, we traded a few emails. The engineer is completing the application to get everything turned in, and that's the last he heard to the court. Okay, so we're inches closer than we were, but we're going, still going in the right direction. It's still in St. James ballpark.
And just bring up the date. I know we done had a meeting with the city and numerous people, St. James on them, but our recent rain and the water height and everything, this is one of our major problems with this Napoleon Canal. It is just filtered up, trees and everything. And basically, our hands are tied with it because no one can dig in those waterways without the Corps of Engineer permit. And as everybody know, I know Mr. Shakes and I know on the East Bank, the problem, you get the Corps of Engineer approved. So I'm just asking the public to be patient with that. And we are moving forward with it to get done.
And just so you guys know, Craig and I spent about an hour out there yesterday riding around. We chased all the canals back off of St. Patrick Street, the big one where that all drains into, and went all the way back to Barrett to make sure it was clear. We got on Barrett and rode it all the way back. So we're in good shape. We just got to get it past that dam down there, okay?
All right.
And to let everybody know, all the land east of Bayou Lafourche drains through those canals right there. I mean, it's everything drains in. It ends up in Lake Des Almond. And so to give background to people that hadn't heard it, we talk about it every month. They used to dredge all that out every 10 years, and about 25 years ago, they were stopped from doing that without major permits, and so St. James didn't want to do it unless they could do it all the way because their water would back up, and so we're working with all the parishes to try to get the right kind of permit to get that done. So it's in the process. It's from all indications, we know that they're going as fast as they can go. And this parish has cleaned everything up to our parish line. And we have put up monies to assist St. James because it's going to assist our people's drainage. We also have a few more things along the four lane that the state is going to be doing to clear out some crosses.
I'll bring some of that up on the report. I'll tell you where we stand on some of that.
Okay. Moving on to item number 10, the West Side DPW building. As far as I know, we did get a bid back.
We did open the bids this afternoon, yes. And all the bids were considerably over our budget.
George, were they all close to each other or was it?
Yes, the five bids, I think they were, well, no, I'll take it back. One, two, three, four, five. Five bids, four of them were fairly close. The closest bid we had was $1,033,000. Mm-hmm. That was the lowest.
About $400,000 over budget.
$403,000. All right. And I guess,
yes,
bottom line, we're going to
get a meeting and get find out some options as to how we can move forward.
Right. So.
Can't go $400,000 over budget.
Once again, it's finance money. So, all right, nothing else on that. We're going to item number 11, update on agreement with the Lemons and the Usuf access to their property. And basically what this is drainage right of ways, and we're dealing with property that drained out of our parish into another parish. and base it, looking at the legal points of view, because that, those people own that property, give us access to it and work an agreement out with it. The attorney, I know that he's looked at that in some situation, and he was, so that's just an update that that's what we are looking from. I talked to Mr. Uso, the property owner, he have no problem with it. I talked to the Lemons, and they don't have any problem with it. It's just a legal situation we have to deal with in a timely manner. Okay, that's the update on that. Any question? No. Item number 12, report, Mr. George Redick.
Okay, let's give you a little bit of catch up. We just talked about Catadonna. We've done considerable ditch work, amount of ditch work in that area. The state, at my request, has done a lot of digging along Highway 70 and 3120 in the area that Kent was talking about. I thought they were gonna come back to 3120 and finish it out this week, but for some reason they didn't come back. I'll have to check and see, maybe the guy was on vacation or something. They're about halfway down. They went all the way down up to what we cleaned, and then turned around and came back up, and they also started from the other end, because one time they had two excavators working at the same time. So they did dig in front of the old restaurant, all the way up to that first crossing that we talked about. They done all the ditch in front of the motel, back that way and back up 3120. So they have done a lot of the work that I asked them to do. Okay. Question on him?
Yeah, I guess me and Ken got the same question.
Rogers, did he say of anything on the timetable on the bridge area? Because that's gonna be.
He told me that the short reach excavators weren't gonna be able to get that, so the long reach was gonna have to come back behind that. I have not seen it yet.
Okay.
But when I check with him to find out why we haven't gotten back, I'll ask him. Like, I tried to call him today and couldn't get him.
Because that'll hold up everything in Aben, Lemonville.
Right. They are aware of the situation. I took them out there, put their hands on it myself, so they know what the problem is.
Yeah. Just to let people know, the rest of the stuff is done. We're waiting on the state for that, and they have limited equipment. So
we are aware. They are aware of it, and I'm still watching.
Yes.
We've done some ditch work near Mount Olive Lane from the River Road back up to Highway 1. There's one that was right in the middle. We finished that one, and we're doing some ditch work. Off of Latino Drive, that's another one, all the way back towards the Loop Road that needed to be done. It's all our major ones, I think, right?
Yeah.
And let you guys know, during recent time, I have lost two people over here. I lost one to East Ascension Drainage. One has retired. I have hired one. He's gonna start work Monday. And we're looking at somebody in Toronto. We may not be able to do that. I've already gone through the applications that were on the file. So if this other doesn't work out, we're gonna have to re-advertise for the other person. I'm glad it came at the end of grass cutting season, but I'm working on it.
I got a question for you, George.
Sure.
You back there by Latina Drive in that little area that belongs to the parish that we take care of the drainage. And during the rain season, those covers that's going across that extension of St. Patrick Street, you know, through the field.
You talking about across the Loop Road?
Loop Road.
The Loop Road, I call it.
945 Loop?
Yeah.
Okay.
I always have, when the rain happened, and you know, they always ask me why the water's not draining. Basically, one of the reasons is, in my mind, is that those covers is not as big, and they have to travel so far as Sugarcane Field, and they don't, I don't know how many crossing they have over there, but it hold up water too there.
It's pretty open back there. Some of the road we traveled the other day, right?
Yeah, and the ones that go across the road pretty clean.
Yeah, pretty clean.
They got a few of them too.
We're back to the same problem, gentlemen. We're back trying to get a lot of water through Bayou Napoleon, through Irish Bayou, back to St. James, and that's where our problem is. And I don't want to point the finger at nobody, but I'm pointing there, yeah. We're clean, we're good.
Okay.
And our guys are staying on top of it.
Okay. All right.
That's all I got.
All right. Mr. Craig, you have anything?
No, that's what it is. The charge went over.
All right. Well, once again, I mean, you know, thank you for that report before that, and I'd just like to let the public, you know, if you do have any items or any work requests or anything you want to done, feel free to call Ms. Peggy's office on the West Bank, and she will definitely do the work request and get it to the correct people to get the job done, you know? Mr. Shakespeare?
Craig, I want to say and make sure you let all the guys know, that they've been doing a fantastic job. A lot has been asked of them through grass cutting season, all the way through the storms and through the rains and stuff like that, and the guys have really stepped up. Congratulations to them. Thanks to you. I know that doesn't happen by accident, so it's good leadership. So we appreciate you and appreciate the guys. And we know George always has a handle on what's going on here, so y'all working together good, and we appreciate it. And now, look, you may have to help him pretty soon because he's getting a little bit older, and he may forget a little bit more, so help him out. You got a birthday tomorrow.
I'm about to say, I thought I heard that too. Mr. President.
A couple of things, next item. You take into consideration that New Year's Day is on our Thursday, first Thursday in January, so you think about that.
Next week, I think the council is having on the second week.
Well,
we're
going to move it wherever the council.
We'll set it to council meeting night.
I know you're way ahead of us, I understand. Yeah. Matter of fact, before we adjourn, Martha, you wouldn't mind coming to the mic?
Do you have $400,000 in your purse?
No, not that. We're not asking that, Martha.
For grants.
Martha, can you give us I have some houses that flooded 3 times already.
Mm-hmm.
And the president was talking about that, what the program is again? Yeah, can you give us a little update on that, what the requirement would be?
Okay, the funding that we got this year was for repetitive loss, severe repetitive loss, and that was a list provided to the parish by FEMA. Those are the homes that we are actually able to do some type of mitigation, either acquire or do elevations. There's no extra funds unless there's a disaster that's required for us to do some assist in elevating homes under that. But they had claims. They filed, this is insurance claims. Now, Kent, I know you're very familiar with this, but they once they have a flood and their home floods, they file their insurance, and then those claims go in, and it's filed with FEMA for repetitive loss numerous times, and that's how they come up with the listing of, you know, how many times it flooded, what was the situation, all of that's documented.
Okay.
So all I can say is if there's homes that are being flooded repetitively, they have to file with their insurance to get the claim, and then that data starts going in, and then that's how they are put on a list.
Okay.
That allows them to get be available for actually for us to go out and do it. On the regular, if there's a storm or some declared emergency, then that's a discretion of what projects or what we need to do for the parish wide, whether it's housing that has to be elevated or a quorum, or is it, you know, wind retro or those type of things.
Okay. So the only other thing that you can add is that there's what they call ICC funds, which is increased cost of compliance, which means if you have insurance and over the period of time you have 50% damage or a total of 50% damage, you can qualify for up to $30,000 to help assist you in
do that
elevate. You can elevate or you can mitigate your property.
Right. So, and we offer that to all of the homes that were under this program, that that's a way of, it's a 75-25 match on these funds that we were allocated. So that enables them to go out and get the extra funds through the ICC, which Kent was alluding to, that helps defer the cost of the elevation or the acquisition.
Okay. So, Martha, if one of any one of these individuals wanted to contact you, they would contact you to get more information on that?
On,
just to bring them up to speed or where to go.
Okay, yeah, that's fine.
All right.
I might not have all the answers, but I'll be happy to take the call and we can document and put them into what we tell them. And this is a form you use if you keep records and this type of thing. It'd be general information, but I'll be happy to do that for you.
Thank you very much.
We can also have on the next disaster, unfortunately, it probably will occur at some point in time in the next few years. If we do qualify for federal funds, we can write to a certain extent our plan, our HMGP, and who's can qualify. So you can, at that point in time, some of the people that wouldn't qualify under their regular insurance or repetitive loss can qualify for these funds. So
that would be something. It's most important and for anyone that has any type of flood damage that they document.
Yes.
Take pictures, keep receipts, put everything, even if they file the claim, put it in a Ziploc or something for records in case something goes on down. They have the actual documents to support it. And I mean, that's the most important thing that I would say, Councilman Joseph, that you could recommend to them. If there is a flooding situation, well, whichever it might be, it's drainage issue or, you know, something mm-hmm. caused a backup, then you got to have that supporting document. Without that, there's nothing that we can really do. I mean, it's got to be filed a claim or show that this is, you know, occurred. And I mean, that's it. Just have them document it.
I, Ms. Martha, appreciate the info, and I would get them to, you know, make sure they look at this meeting, and then they contact you.
That'll be fine. Thank you, sir.
Thank you again. All right. Item number 13, setting dates, time for the next meeting. We already know we're going to go with the January meeting with the council for December. December 4th?
5:15.
Yeah, December 4th at 5:15. All right. Thank you, Ms. Bain.
Motion to adjourn.
Motion adjourned. Meeting adjourned.